Morning, church.
Morning.
Great to see all of you this morning on this beautiful winter day. To God be the glory this morning. We're looking forward to worshiping together this morning, and we're just grateful that you're all here today. For those that are listening online, we welcome you into the sanctuary of Forever Grace Church, where God is still on the throne and Jesus is still Lord. So we're praising Him this morning. Thank you for being here with us this morning. The announcements are on the back. They're pretty much the way we've been looking at them. Please read your announcements and go through those so we don't have to spend hours on that. Invariably, somebody during the week would go, hey, when's the, well, it's in your bulletin there. One thing is not in your bulletin for you ladies, and most of you received it in your hand today. There is a little, you should have gotten a little handout today about the women's gathering that's on March 5th down at Margaret Blevin's house. That I think it's a painting party. I think she wants her house painted, I think is what she wants. But, what's that? So if you want to be involved in that and have some good times with some of the ladies, that's available for you. There is a sign-up sheet on the way out, ladies. They'd like for you to sign up if you would. That way they've got an idea of how many to prepare for. So if you would do that, be so kind. The Ash Wednesday thing's on there. That's this Wednesday, by the way. Ash Wednesday is already, this week. It's coming up this week. And I'll be here from 7 to 8 on that morning, on Wednesday morning, and I'll be here from 5 to 6 on that evening. If you'd like to come through, it's come and go, Ash Wednesday. So if you'd like to come in, receive the ashes, pray for a while if you'd like, be here, you're welcome to do that. And we'd love for you to come through. Good Friday and Easter are now on the bulletin, so you see that. Church camp information. There's a lot of information for church camp, so if you've got kids that may be interested or you'd like for them to go, that information's back there. I would tell you, if you want to talk to Margaret Blevins, Margaret has almost all the information on any camp, on the camps. If you'd like to talk to her, she can help you through that. But I will tell you this for you that are listening in and that are here. Through donations of others in the church and through Forever Grace Church's accounts, we're going to pay 100% for every child that wants to go to a church camp here in this area. And so there's no reason financially why you shouldn't go do that, right? So that's a hallelujah great thing, right? Yeah, it's good stuff. I think that's about it, huh? We do have an upcoming sermon series on bridge builders, so we'll be talking about that as we go along here. So, anything else? Anything I missed? I know I kind of rushed through that. I like to rush through announcements. Anyone else? Anything? Good. How about prayer requests this morning? I will tell you, as you're thinking about that, I will tell you that Alice McKinney is doing pretty well. Roland is home with her this morning, again, listening online. Hi, Alice and Roland. They have a nurse coming in this morning. She is getting some physical therapy finally. And so she's doing quite well right now for having a broken hip. She goes back to the doctor tomorrow to have that checked and everything. So that's good stuff. A lot of people have been praying for her. And Roland is very grateful. He calls me frequently and tells how much he's thankful for this family. So, Vicki, where are you, Vicki? Betsy Jones, Linda's, I can't remember. She's had her bone marrow transplant. Her counts are now where they're supposed to be, right? So she's making improvements. Betsy and Ken are gone right now, but that's Betsy's sister, Linda, that we've been praying for that's, I thought was in Chicago, but she's actually in Arizona. There's not much that difference. But she's doing good. Yes, Bill? The people of Ukraine. Bill's asking for prayer for them, the people of Ukraine. Yes, it's I don't think we can even begin to imagine here what that's like or how difficult that is. I'll also give you a praise. The praise is Dr. Bill. I call him Dr. Bill. Bill Blevins has been working on the door, the new doors, wood doors, and his part of it is now finished. Did that change since I talked to you a little bit ago?
Yeah. We got issues.
Okay. Anyway. Bill's got issues. Oh, Bill didn't have issues. Anyway, we're close. and we're working on the hardware. We got to get all the crash bars and all that stuff, but we're getting much closer. Okay, we'll get there. Anyone else this morning with like a prayer request or a praise you'd like to share? You're so quiet. Let's go to prayer this morning. Why not, right? Let's go to prayer. Father, thank you for this day of life you've given us, the day that you've put before us, the day that you may or may not have a challenge for us today. But Father, we thank you for the good news that we know Jesus Christ is alive. And we praise you for that, Father, because with him, all things are possible. You gave your son to us, Father. You gave him to us to take care of the things that we need taken care of, because, Father, you knew that we couldn't do it on our own. We needed your help. And today we call on you to walk us through the next steps, to walk us through this day. But more importantly, even today, Father, is that your Holy Spirit would come descend upon this family, not only within the body of this family here in the sanctuary, but those that are listening online today. Father, we just ask that your Holy Spirit would descend upon us, because your Holy Spirit will speak to us. The Holy Spirit will talk to us about what we need to know and what we need to think about and what we need to learn, and it will walk us through it. Today, Father, in your house, we praise you. You heard the prayer requests go up from around here. We have praises of progress on the building. We have praises on Alice McKinney feeling better and doing better. But we also know, Father, there are challenges within the body of Christ. We ask, Father, that you would touch those people that need it the most, that you would walk them through this. So today, Father, as we worship and we thank you for the sunshines, we're going to thank you for the sun that's shining on the inside here with us today, bringing us hope, bringing us the faith and the love that we so much needed. And Father, we'd be remiss this morning if we didn't speak about the families in Ukraine that are suffering right now. May you hold their hands. May you protect them. May you comfort them. May you be with them. So today, Father, as we enjoy your music, as we enjoy your scriptures, as we enjoy the fellowship of each brother and sister in here, may you receive the glory today for all things and all ways. And Lord, we just praise you today. In the precious name of Jesus, amen and amen. Kenlin, I think you're pinch hitting today for Wyatt. We should have prayed for Wyatt. Wyatt's sick today. So Wyatt and also Betsy Fry, they're both ill today. So, Kenlin, thank you for doing this.
Psalms 5, 11 through 12. But let all who take refuge in you be glad. Let them sing for joy. Spread your protection over them, that those who love your name may rejoice in you. Surely, Lord, you bless their righteous. You surround them with your favor as with a shield.
Thank you very much, Kenlin.
And if you'll rise with me, we'll sing this morning. We'll begin with Trust and Obey.
When we walketh the Lord in the light of his word, what a glory he sheds on our way. While we do his good will, he abides with us still. And who will trust and obey? Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not a shadow can rise, not a cloud in the skies,
What a friend we have in Jesus. If you'll be seated, Dan's going to lead us in prayer.
Pastor Gary asked me to get up here and do a prayer this morning. I went into shock, so he thought that was meaning yes. Let's go to the throne. Dear Lord, Father in heaven, thank you for all the many, many blessings you give to us each and every day. Bless this Forever Grace Church, the people in it and those online. And bless those, Lord, that need your healing touch. Be there for them. Bring them back to this church. Lord, we ask that you bless our pastors, Gary, Casey, Pastor Jack. Please give them the wisdom and the knowledge to understand your words and to be able to teach us your words so we can be a light in this world. Bless our youth. They are our hope and our future. Bless our country, Lord. We need you back in our schools and in our government. We hear wars and rumor of wars, Lord, but we know that you're always there. In the name of your wonderful Son, Jesus Christ, who died for all our sins, amen.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit.
There is hope.
What do you say after a song like that? Okay, you get up here and be the pastor now. What do you say after a song like that? Hallelujah. That's what you say, right? Hallelujah. You know, we've been on this series of hope for the last 4 weeks. We started out with hope for the weary, hope for the broken, hope for the underdog, hope for the broken. No, hope for the doubter. That's what it was. That's pretty good for an old man to remember all those. I don't know how you. Amen. Yeah. So we're done with that series, right? So the choir just sang about hope, right? So I was sitting in this choir practice about 10 days ago, and Marilyn said, we're going to sing a song about hope. I said, you do know the series is over last week, right? I mean, week before, right? She said, yeah, but I want to sing about hope. It was right, huh? It was the right thing, right? But I tell you, I was sitting in that practice, and Dr. Bill started reading his little thing that he did before. He always says something before we start, and he started reading to practice to go into that song. And I don't know if you all picked up on this or not, but all that he read there was scripture. It wasn't opinion; it was scripture. So after the practice was over, I said, what scriptures were there? I knew two of them. I was positive two of them, and I thought I knew maybe one of the others. I had one of them wrong. But we're going to share some of that with you today. Because when I was praying over what I should do today, which was be to start on a new topic, I felt like summarizing what hope was about was where I was supposed to be. I don't know if I kept this in my hands today. This is what we sang from today. I know they all had books. You couldn't tell it, but this was really what it looked like. I want you to hear these words. I know you heard them in song, but sometimes when you listen to something in song, you're watching some of the people sing, and you don't catch all the words. It starts out, through the darkness breaks the light. Out of death, he brings new life. From the ashes, beauty will rise. There is hope in the night. From our sorrow, springs new joy. Out of sin, grace lifts its voice. In our weakness, comes strength to fight. There is hope in the night. Sing, O saints, a song of praise. Let fearless faith break every chain. God's mercy saves. We testify. We testify. Amen. There is hope in the night. Over hatred, love prevails. Past our doubts, truth never fails. In our blindness, his word gives sight. There's hope in the night. So sing, O saints, a song of praise. Let fearless faith break every chain. God's mercy saves. We testify. There's hope in the night. Hallelujah, hallelujah. This anthem echoes forevermore. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, our endless hope is Christ the Lord. Pray with me. Father, be with us now as we comb through your scriptures, as we break down some of your scriptures, some of your word, Father, today, so that we, as your saints, as the people who love you so much, can gather from this scripture what we need to have, Father, to take us through this next week, to fight the fight, to testify what we know, and to praise you with hallelujahs. So today, Father, be with us. Speak your words today, Father, to this family. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. So the first scripture, and I put these in the bulletin, and I'm gonna take it a little further, but the first scripture was, Dr. Bill didn't know this, but this is one of my favorite scriptures in the whole Bible. Isaiah 40:31 is a scripture that I've leaned on for years. And so it seems appropriate today that we talk about it. Casey's back in the seat today, but I don't know whether I gave you Isaiah first or not, but Isaiah 40:31. Okay, so let me take that off there for a second. Let me back up for you. As always, as I always try to teach you, always go in and look what's before, even after it. Get some kind of idea of where we're at there, okay? So 40:31, let me back up to, I don't know if I gave you this or not, but I'm going to back up to 40:28. And it says this, "Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom." 29 says, "He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak." 30 says, "Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall." Let me hold on to that before we go to 31. So for you young people that come through that door every morning, you go out of here and you're tired. You're not the only ones. So is your mom and dad. So are your grandparents. So are the people of this world. We get tired. We get weary. We get afraid of war, because what does war do? Makes us weary. Makes us tired. Oh, I know, the war's not here in the United States. It's not. But it still affects us, doesn't it, no matter where it's at? And you young people, I know, you get tired. I get it. I understand it. Don't forget, I've got 7 children and 14 grandchildren. I've watched it. I've seen it. I got one grandson that'd sleep to noon every day if we let him. He will not grow tired or weary. God will not grow tired or weary. And his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary. So if you're weary today, and we talked about that, he's there for you. Even youths grow tired and weary. So this is the great verse that I want you to know that Dr. Bill read. "But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint." Is that not the greatest verse you've ever heard? "But those who hope in the Lord." So my question to you today, what do people really do that don't have any hope in the Lord? I don't know. They do things they're not supposed to do. They do things they're not supposed to do because they're seeking something. And when you have that hope, when you have that true hope, I could preach the whole hour just on that topic alone. I spent an hour with Jack and Susie this week, and I'm fired up this week. Y'all want to get fired up a little bit, go visit this couple here for just a little bit. It's not just them. It's a lot of you that are doing that. I'm going to go to Isaiah. We're going to hit on Isaiah, which is, not Isaiah. We're going to go to Jeremiah. Jeremiah 29 and 11 is what I gave Casey. Casey, I'm going to run up to that, so hang on. And 29:11 is Jeremiah 29:11 is one you all have heard before many, many, many times. We're gonna talk about it in a little bit. Let me tell you before we get to it. This is 29 is a letter to the exiles. So let me just give you the beginning of this. This is the text of the letter that the prophet Jeremiah sent from Jerusalem to the surviving elders among the exiles and to the priests, the prophets, and all the other people Nebuchadnezzar had carried into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. This is what the Lord Almighty, the God of Israel, says to all those I carried into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. Build houses, settle down, plant gardens, eat what they produce, marry and have sons and daughters, find wives for your sons and daughters, and so that they may have sons and daughters of their own. Increase in number, do not decrease. Also seek the peace and prosperity of the city to which I have carried you into. So you get the gist of what this is about. So then when we get down to 29:11 of Jeremiah, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and to not harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." Now, this scripture is often used wrong, in my opinion. Because, see, when you hit that word prosper, there's a lot of people that take that, "He's going to make me wealthy. I am just going to, if I got hope in him and I believe in him, he is going to make me wealthy." Which, well, I don't want us to get off on the wrong place there. Just it's to prosper. Oh, sure, prosper could be to make you, but the prosper is to make you what? What's it mean here? When you look at that word prosper in here, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. I mean, he's going to help you, right? He's going to do what he needs to do to make you who you need to be, whether you're wealthy in money or wealthy in, I always say, you know, God's never made me wealthy in money, but he's made me wealthy in love of my family. He's prospered me in so many other ways. He's blessed me in so many other ways. Vicki and I are not wealthy people in money. We're fine. We're comfortable. All of you are comfortable. I get that. But it's what he's given us to help us through day by day by day. That's where he prospers us. The daily activities are, if we have that, because he's not going to harm us. He's not here to harm us. I just get so irritated with pastors who stand up in the pulpit and they browbeat you and tell you, "You're going to die, you're going to go to hell, you're going to..." This book is a love story. This is a love story. He loves you so much, even in those days where you don't even love yourself. And trust me, you've all been there. There are days when you didn't love yourself. There are days when I haven't loved myself. But he still did, no matter what. Gosh, I am fired up today. I don't know if you could tell that or not. Ugh. Plans to give you hope and a future. You see, you can be anything you want to be. You can be anything you want to be with God. Anything you want to be. But do we use our entire heart for him? Do we use everything we have and say to him, "Whatever it takes"? I spent about 30 seconds on my knees over here a while ago. And all I said was, God, I can't do this without you. So you're going to have to do it. Because those folks that have been in the pulpit before, like Jack and Gary, and those that have filled a pulpit before, and Jack told me this early on when I started this ministry, about his story about how he could do it on his own one time, and he went and he failed miserably. Can you imagine Jack Scott being in a pulpit and failing miserably? But he says he did. And Susie says, yes, he did. Confirmation that he was awful. Because he said, I thought I was going to be the next Billy Graham, I guess, and I didn't need really to go ask God for help that day. But you can take it to where it doesn't have to be just a pastor in ministry. You know, it can be in anything you're doing. If you don't take God with you, if you don't take him with you, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. So Romans 5 is the other one that Dr. Bill used this morning. Romans 5. So this topic is on peace and hope. Let me run into this a little bit. When Casey and I started on this series at the end of January, right? We started on this the last Sunday in January. And we don't use series a whole lot. I know you all know that now. We don't use series a whole lot. We usually go topic by topic and where God's leading us. And someone asked me, well, if you follow what God wants you to do all the time, how can you then set a series and say, this is what the topic's going to be? Well, let me just tell you. We might have the topic, and we have an outline. We can pull up an outline that shows us exactly what words to say on those series. But I can assure you that Casey never used that outline. Not once. Because we're going to follow what God wants us to do, not what the outline says. He may have led us to hope, and so we picked up on the hope series, and he may have given us a scripture in there, which, you know, there's scripture there, you're going to read it. But I will tell you that there's sometimes in a series you look at a scripture and go, that's not going to fit my people. And God's saying, it's not going to fit my people. You need to use this one. So we try very hard to do what God wants us to do. And I feel confident that 10 days ago, when I heard Dr. Bill read these scriptures before that song, that he was saying to me, I don't care what you're thinking about right now, this is what I want you to think about. Hope. I kind of made fun because the song says hope in the night. I was like, well, what about during the day? What about, is it just in the night? But you see, many times in the night, in the dark, is where we need that hope the most. Now, you may be in a place where even in the day, you're in the dark right now. A lot of times this time of year, we get a lot of family that are dealing with the depressive part of this season, and the dark for them is even during the day. So there is hope all the time. When I read this peace and hope out of Romans that Paul wrote, he says, therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand. And we boast the hope, and we boast in the hope of the glory of God. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope. And here it is, verse 5. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. You all, if you all haven't been listening to Pastor Casey's Bible study, let me tell you, he's been in Hebrews. I didn't give you this because it just now hit me. He was in Hebrews 11 a week or so ago. He's past that now, if you didn't read this, you should go read Hebrews 11. Now, everybody in here knows Hebrews 11 starts out with, now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. Everyone knows that scripture. But if you go on through Hebrews 11, it says in verse 3, it says, by faith we understand. In 4, it says, by faith Abel brought God a better offering. In 5, by faith Enoch was taken from this life. In 6, and it says, and without faith, it is impossible to please God. And 7 says, by faith Noah. And by 8 says, by faith Abraham. It's Hebrews about faith, right? And also, without faith, it's impossible to please God. Now, maybe you're thinking to me, well, I don't care if I please God or not. Well, you should. Sorry. Hope I stepped on every toe in here that thought they should. But you need to please God, because without Him, that hope is not there, right? I'm not sure how I got off on Hebrews there, but when he read that the other day, when he was going through that, I began to read that, and I thought, it's all about faith, but it also tells us without it, you know? I'm off on tangents here today, but that's okay, because this whole topic really got me fired up. I think it's 1 Corinthians 13:13, I think. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. I know I'm kind of all over the board here today, but I'm telling you that hope made the top three. With Paul, hope made the top three: faith, hope, and love. The greatest of those is love. We all know that. We all know God is love. It's the greatest of these. We're supposed to love our neighbors as ourselves. Love is a big deal. But when you put these three together, faith, which I just talked about, and hope, is in the top three. Now, you all could put some other things in there if you want to that are in your top three or four. But it says, and now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. I have so many things I wanted to tell you this morning, and I couldn't get my brain wrapped around everything that I needed to tell you, because it's so important that this church have hope. And you individually, it's important that you have hope. We've been doing some, Vicki and I have been leading some groups of conversations, people within this church, about some things, the future of this church. And we will continue doing a few of those. Some of you are still involved with some of them. Some of you been a part of it already. Some of you may not be a part of it, but it's okay. We're just trying to get some ideas about the future of this church. And I will tell you, after having four or so sessions with various people, I will tell you that there's great hope in this church forever. The strength of the people that we've been talking to, and some of you yet to be involved with these, but the strength of the people in these focus groups that we've been talking about is amazing. Truly amazing. There's so much hope from this body. You look around and we have, how many people we have here today, Vicki? 68. We have 68 people, and we've got, I'm looking out here, and I know we got 10 or 12 people that are regulars here that are sick and gone at home today, at least. The Fry family and Jarvis family, Nodehams are gone, and Joneses are gone. And so if I just quickly name, look, I mean, we've got 65 to 80 people that come through these doors all the time. What great hope we have. I was blessed this week to be able to meet with a couple that are sitting here in this congregation that are going to meet, that are going to get married this summer. And they're a young couple, and I got to tell you, there's hope. There's love. There's faith. I ask them to be a part of this church, to continue, because we need the young people of this church. We need the young people, and I want them to have hope. I want them to have the understanding that with their faith and their hope and their love, all things are possible with God. Such a neat couple. Nate, Valerie, you did a good job. I'm talking about Avery and Forrest. They're sitting back here in the back, and such a neat couple. But see, that's the way every time I sit down. When I sat down with the Scotts this week, and Jody was there too, it was that same love and that same hope, the hope that these two have for Forever Grace Church is over the top. I hope you do. I hope you have that much hope in God. I hope that everyone who walks through the doors has the hope of God in their heart. Because if you don't have hope, what do you live for? Seriously. And in these cold, long winter days, sometimes I know we search for that hope. I know some days it's just gets a little dreary. That's the reason I'm so grateful for the sunshine today. The sun shining on the canes back there, right on top of them back there. That's awesome. So this morning, as I close out of here, I just hope that you've taken something from the topics of hope for the weary and hope for the broken and hope for the doubters and hope for the underdogs and the hope for all of you. I hope you take something from that. I'll tell you on March 20th, which is what, 3 weeks from now, Jack and Susie Scott are going to be up here in the pulpit. And they're going to start talking about spiritual gifts. We're going to move into the spiritual gifts because we want you to know about those and what they're about. And they're going to be sharing, coming up here on that Sunday and spend about 40 or 45 minutes with you sharing about spiritual gifts. You see, we want to put things in your hands that are usable for you to go out of here tomorrow and the next day and the next day and use it in your day-to-day activities. Some of you have spiritual gifts you don't know you have. Some of you have spiritual gifts that you know you have and you're afraid to use them. If someone would have told me before 1984 when I met Jesus, if somebody would have told me before May of 1984 when I found Jesus that someday I would be in a pulpit, I would have probably called him a name of some sort. That probably wouldn't have been pleasant. Seriously, I'm telling you, just the way it is. It took me out of my comfort zone. Completely. I've told this before. I had a speech class at Indiana State. I hated the speech class. I didn't even want to be in it. And then they did this thing called an impromptu speech. Oh, I wanted to be anywhere else but in there. But you see, it doesn't really matter always what I want. When I found Jesus, he told me, this is what you need to do. Now, some of you are looking at me going, but I'm having fun right now doing what I'm doing, so I don't know why I should do this Jesus thing with you. That's between you and him to figure out. But let me tell you, when you figure it out, I was with some Christian brothers yesterday, and I heard a really good conversation from a man who had been in a lot of trouble, and when he found Jesus and how it changed his life. And I just was like, holy cow, and now he's a youth pastor. And I look at that and I think, he had hope. He found the hope that he was looking for. Let's pray today. Father, thank you for this time you've given us. You're such an amazing God who loves us all so much. Even when we can't find that hope, you guide us to it. The Holy Spirit speaks to us and guides us to that moment. Father, today, for all those that are listening online on Livestream, and some of our family that are home ill today are listening, we have people from Florida to Terre Haute to Virginia to Wisconsin, from all over, Father, that all over here that are listening to us and hearing your words spoken today, Father, would you bless them? Would you touch them? You promise in Jeremiah that you will prosper them, just as you will prosper this family that's here in the sanctuary today, Father. We come here to worship you today, Father. We come here to give you glory today, Father. We come here to give you, to listen to your music and to your scripture and to fellowship together as brothers and sisters in Christ. And we just thank you today for that, Father. Thank you for giving us the hope that we needed. For the hope that will take us to heaven someday, where you will welcome us. May you receive the glory today, Father, in all things. In all ways. May you help those today that are questioning what you have for them. Will you help those that are questioning this prosper thing? Will you let them fly like eagles? And let them know, Father, that you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and you are above all, and you will give them hope. You will give them what they need. Day by day, if we but ask. So today, Lord, precious name of Jesus, we're going to pray this prayer to you today in the precious name of Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day and forgive us as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Sing this last song, Linda.
And if you'll rise, we'll sing.
Our hearts in grief.
do have this last scripture that it's Romans 15:15, and it's a benediction that Paul wrote, and I thought I'd use it as we go out of here. It was still part of what Dr. Bill said this morning. And it reads this way in 15:15. No, 15. Is it 15:15? What is it? 13? What do you got back there, Casey? 15:13, sorry. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Spirit. Father, thank you for this day that you've given us. Bless those who have come here. Bless those that have listened in this morning. Bless them as they go out of here. And Father, may you receive the glory today in Jesus' name. Go in peace, everyone. We love you.